Commander, incoming transmissions.
On what channel?
5, 7, 11, 14, and 3.
This is more traffic than the station can handle with our current complement of staff.
Yeah, no kidding. Incoming priority message on channel 9.
Ensign, reroute channel 9 to my console.
You've got it.
I need to dock my ship and unload my cargo now.
How did you access this priority channel?
That is none of your business. Quark owes me.
I will require more time.
No, no more time. If Quark cannot handle the amount of incoming ships, why is this station even open? I'm taking my business elsewhere.
My personal log. Business day 567-367, Tower of Commerce, Standard Time. Well, Moogie, I did it. I finally did it. I got a great deal on an abandoned space station, and the Federation was even willing to tractor it in for me here, into the Romulan Neutral Zone.
What a stupid human and Romulan idea. Since they couldn't stop fighting each other, their idea was a zone of nothing, where neither of them could go, but everyone else could. And now, Moogie, here I am. No longer am I just the owner of a simple bar, but the owner of an entire space station, a potential gold mine for commerce. But let me tell you, Moogie, I had no idea running my own space station would be so expensive in both time and latinum. I remember the good old days in my bar, taking customers' money, giving them some sort of advice. They listened, they kept drinking, and most importantly, they kept paying. Now I have to worry about everything. Whether it's tied in with my profits or not. Manning the station, docking port this, realigning that, replacing missing whatevers. This area of space doesn't seem to be important to anyone, but now there are all kinds of ships showing up from different planets and sectors. The way I figure it, Moogie, they know I'm a good businessman and this is a good place to do business. In fact, Moogie, just the other day...
Quark, a Valdarian ship has just left without leaving their cargo.
The captain seemed quite upset and said that you owe him.
I am unable to maintain a logical progression of ship docking traffic with our current staff. We need more people if you intend to maintain an increased level of business.
You handle it. That's what I'm paying you for.
Sir, a Talarian ship has just broken off communication and is leaving. They've gone to warp.
Let them go. Quark, another ship has just departed without leaving their cargo. There are more ships attempting to dock and the power relays are overloading. I maintain our current staff shortage is a detriment to logical operation of this station.
Hiring more people will cut into my profits.
In that case, Mr. Quark, what would you have me do?
There goes my profit margins.
May I remind you, sir, you are the commander of this station.
May I also remind you,
Deep Space Nine's Captain Sisko had Kira and Dax in operations. They were seasoned crew members. Captain Sisko also had O'Brien handling a fully staffed engineering department. There was the doctor and innumerable Bajorans and Federation staff. We simply need more personnel. Is there not a rule of acquisition that states, in order to achieve more profit, you must increase traffic? Do you want to continue losing opportunities, such as the recent freighter that left without earning you your latinum?
All right, I'm convinced, but it's still going to cost me. You'd better find me some quality people to interview. I am not going to hire just anyone who wanders onto my station. Quark out. No matter how hard I try not to, seems like I'm getting stuck in the people business after all.
I do not understand the logic of the Federation sending us an experienced engineer with nothing in exchange.
Well, I think it was nice of the Federation to send him, but we'll have to see how it works out. However, maybe they had ulterior motives.
One to beam over. Energize.
There is one more to beam over, please.
Ensign, one more to beam over.
It's a large pink tribble. I've never seen anything like that. It looks like a big pink mushroom.
Fascinating. I do not recall seeing this species before. What is it?
It is Nibbles. It is a very special tribble. It belongs to my wife, Lieutenant Kanara. She is serving aboard the USS Sandstorm. She did not want me to be lonely, so she insisted that Nibbles come and be with me while I am stationed here.
My name is Tresic. I am the station manager. This is Azara, our chief engineer.
Hello.
May I ask, why is it you and your wife, instead of owning a cat or a dog, choose to own a large, pink, special, one-of-a-kind tribble?
Well, there is a story, but if I tell you, please do not tell anyone else. Is that okay?
Yes.
You see, the Federation knows that humans like tribbles, and tribbles like humans, but we all know that tribbles do not like Klingons, and yet we are at peace with the Klingon Empire. We also know that tribbles are born pregnant and reproduce way too often. You feed them, they reproduce. You don't feed them, they reproduce. They have caused havoc on many societies and even planets, not to mention the problems with the Klingons. And so, the Federation decided to do a secret experiment to genetically modify tribbles.
Really? Well, did it work?
It worked. Nibbles was the first, and it actually likes my wife, who is half Klingon and half human. But there were some side effects that we are still discovering about. Both Kanara and I are observing Nibbles to see how things work out. We protect it since it is one of a kind, and many intelligent people were involved in creating it. We are seeing how this experiment will evolve.
What kind of side effects does it have?
Well, we are not sure of all of them yet, but Nibbles is really smart. And Nibbles can communicate in a way. And I am even learning how to communicate with him. And we also just found out that it can change colors.
Do you mean it changes colors when it's listening to music?
Hey, what's going on out here? And where is my new engineer? I thought I heard something odd out here and... What
is that? And why is it on my station?
Nibbles.
And what is a Nibbles?
It appears this life form is his co-worker and some sort of companion pet. It would be similar to a human's seeing eye dog, but with more intelligence, I presume.
And apparently it comes with cool colors. Is it housebroken? We don't exactly have pet waste stations on the promenade, you know.
How did this thing get that big? I have never seen a pink tribble before. It's not pregnant, is it?
It is housebroken, and it is not pregnant, but that is a long story.
I don't even want to know. Time is money, and we're wasting time.
Mr. Quark, I am Lieutenant Hansen, your new chief engineer, on loan from the Federation.
Why is this thing purring? What does that mean?
It means it likes you.
Well, Lieutenant Hansen, I guess it can stay. But I hold you personally responsible for this thing. If it costs me any latinum or causes any trouble, it goes!
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir. Believe me, it will be no trouble at all. And perhaps in the future, it will save us trouble, Yasher.
Some type of human humor, I suppose. Ha! Ha! But again, any trouble with your tribble, it goes!
Who are you?
I'm Q2. I hear that you're looking for people to help run this space station of yours. I thought I might learn some new things from the little denizens of your galaxy here. Seriously, Quark, I can do whatever you'd like. Just ask.
You hear that, Moogie? Another Q on my station. Okay, fine. Make me a big pile of latinum.
That's not what I meant. Change me back.
Now do it right. Give me 100 bars of latinum right here on my desk.
Too easy. There wouldn't be any fun in watching you run the station if you had all the latinum you wanted. Besides, I thought you needed someone to help run station ops.
You couldn't handle that.
Try me.
All right, then. Three ships are trying to dock, one's trying to leave, and then all of a sudden, you get an emergency distress signal. What would you do?
I would just make them all vanish. I would send them way back into the Big Bang or do something funny. I'd send them 15 minutes into the past.
You can't do that. That would create a time paradox.
Fine, I would send them into the future then, whenever.
That's not the point. Never mind. How would you keep order on my space station?
It's simple. Oops. Wrong universe.
What was that? I'm trying to run a space station here, not some kind of oppressive empire.
Maybe this isn't the best place for me after all.
Finally. He's gone. This is Quark. Send in the next applicant.
Yes, sir.
Hansen to Lieutenant Azara, please come to engineering immediately.
Azara here, on my way.
Hello, name's Quark.
I own the station, chief of everything, and what position are you applying for today, Mr. Welling whom?
Actually, it's Wellington. So pleased to meet you, Lawrence Wellington.
All right, Mr. Wellington. What position are you here for?
I'd love to get something in engineering. I love all the devices and gadgets that you get to play with in work with in engineering.
I see. Do you have any experience in engineering?
Well, no, not really, but I did help out with a replicator once, but just couldn't get the pea soup quite right. It kept coming out so thin.
Any references?
References. Oh, yes, just one.
Just one?
Yes. But it's a big one.
Go on.
Miles O'Brien.
You know Miles O'Brien?
Of course I do. He was the chief engineer aboard Deep Space Nine. Why, do you know that one time he was...
I know who Chief O'Brien is. How do you know him?
Well, he's a rather distant relative.
What do you mean by distant relative?
Well, as we sit here today, he's about 42 light years away. I'd call that distant, wouldn't you? Little joke, sorry. But actually, he really is a distant relative. He keeps his distance from me because he feels that I'm the crazy one. Can you imagine O'Brien thinking that I'm the crazy one? You should have seen all the junk that he collected over the years and stored in his quarters. Keiko having to move it here, move it there. Nobody could figure out what all that stuff was.
Maybe they were his collection of engineering tools?
Well, I hadn't considered that. Of course, I wouldn't know the difference between an engineering tool and a pea soup spoon. Anyway, engineering, that's my interest.
I see, Mr. Wellington. Well, if something comes up within the next 3 to 4 months, I'll let you know.
That would be great. I would love to have another go at the replicator. Did I tell you the pea soup kept coming out so thin?
Yes, you did mention that several times, in fact. Thank you.
Thank you. Cheerio, and may the latinum be with you.
Lieutenant Hansen, is there a problem?
I do not know how you did that. However, the power couplings are still overloaded, and I cannot use all of the docking ports. I would really appreciate any suggestions you may have.
Well, if it were me, I'd reroute some of the power from the lower cargo bays. And since the security force fields aren't functional, you could reroute that power too. This station has so much outdated Cardassian technology, you're probably going to have to rebuild everything to get it all to play nice together.
Oh, I knew this assignment was strange when it came from Director Bond.
What was that?
Never mind. Nibbles, I told you not to use that language around these people. If you could just monitor the situation, and I will be right back. Thank you. Thank you very much.
You're welcome.
So, Miss Jezebel, what can I call you?
You can call me Jezzy.
All right, Jezzy then. Seems like you've had a lot of experience in a lot of different fields. It says here that you were a computer programmer, a rocket scientist, a housekeeper, and a fireworks factory employee. Tell me, Jezzy, why so many different careers?
I like to try different things, you know.
I see. Well then, do you mind if I contact the last hotel you worked at as a reference?
You can't really do that.
And why not?
Because the hotel had a fire and it's no longer in business.
A fire?
Yeah, the whole hotel burned down. It must have been a faulty plug or a frayed vacuum cleaner cord. The fire was rather beautiful to watch. It really wasn't my fault.
Hey, hey, calm down. No one said it was your fault. Well then, how about the safe and sane fireworks company on the moon of Minima 7?
Not really, no.
Let me guess. There was an accident?
Yes, there was an accident. How did you know?
Lucky guess. So what happened?
There was a small explosion.
Small explosion? Well, that doesn't sound so bad, but why would a small explosion keep me from contacting the company?
Because the small explosion set off a bigger explosion, which set off an even bigger explosion.
I think I know where this is going.
Yes, it was amazing. Eventually, the whole moon blew into a million pieces.
The whole moon?
Yep, all gone.
Fine, then how about the Wars R Us Robotics Company?
No.
Oh, really? Let me guess, there was a fire or an accident or something?
There was an accident.
Oh, really?
Yes, there was a coding problem on a prototype robot.
And then it blew up or caught fire?
No, no fire, no electrical problems, no boom.
Okay then, so what went wrong?
It sort of went cyber insane.
Cyber insane?
Yes, it went crazy and destroyed everything. It attacked my supervisor first. He was a mean manager anyway, and he got what he deserved. Most of the upper management was also lost in the accident. The business shut down a few weeks later.
Cyber insane. Well then, Jesse, thank you for interviewing for this position. And if anything opens up in the next few months, I'll make sure to contact you. Now you better hurry or you'll miss the next shuttle out of here.
But...
Hurry, hurry! Time is money! First Q2 and then that second guy shows up. No wonder Chief O'Brien keeps... Ah!
Job.
Excuse me?
I job you.
You want to give me a job? I get it! You want a job! So tell me, Mr.
Scar.
What position are you interviewing for?
Security.
I see that. Any qualifications?
Can fight. Can shoot. Can smash me big.
Well, those are some excellent qualifications, so tell me, do you have any investigatory experience, any background in...
B-B.
Well, yes, that's a very strong qualification, and then if you forward me some references and your resume, I'll get back to you in 3 months.
Okay, we have a deal. 1,000 bars of latinum deposited into my account, and you get 100 quadrilutes of chemosite.
Agreed, Ragnar. But where can we make a transfer? I don't trust you to beam anything onto my ship.
I don't trust you either. I would never expect you to accept a transfer directly. We can use that new station in the Romulan neutral zone. I hear it's a free-for-all over there. Be there at 1300 arms. I will give you the transport coordinates at that time.
Incoming message on secure channel.
Put it through.
Quark. I'll be arriving at your station shortly. I will need the transporter coordinates for my cargo when I arrive. The fewer who see my ship, the better.
Captain Uglehoff, my old friend, my dear, old, dangerous, smuggling friend. I'll get right back to you with those transporter coordinates. Quark out. Quark to Terezic. Have someone go down to lower levels and look for 8 gray and purple cases with yellow labels, and then get me the transporter coordinates.
Contact Gorgon on ship.
Communications open, sir.
Gorgon, you can scan coordinates 13, 31, 44 to confirm the chemo site is there. Transfer the latinum to my account now. And if you try to beam it out without payment, I will blow you out of the sky.
Ragnar, I would never try to cheat you. Done.
Flash has the latinum been deposited in my account?
Yes, Captain.
Gordon, nice doing business with you again. I think this station is going to make a lot of latinum for both of us.
Agreed.
Sir, a Toglian ship just left without authorization.
Understood. We will deal with that later. Right now, I need you to go to Cargo Bay 12, Section 13, and ensure the cargo there is secure. I need it ready for delivery in 2 days.
Aye, sir. Sir, Jacob's here. You did say Cargo Bay 12, Section 13, right?
That is correct. Is there a problem?
It's just that there's nothing in Section 13. Nothing at all.
Are you positive? There are supposed to be 8 gray and purple cases with yellow labels. Check again.
Matching that description, sir.
I've done a thorough search of the entire area.
Very well, Ensign. Report back to Ops and I will inform Mr. Quark.
Aye, sir. Jacobs out.
Mr. Quark, Ensign Jacobs has reported in from Cargo Bay 12. There are no gray and purple cases with yellow labels in Section 13. There is nothing matching the description you gave us in that cargo bay.
What? No! No! What do you mean there's nothing down there?
Sir, the cases you asked us to check on are nowhere in Cargo Bay 12. Ensign Jacobs performed a search of the entire area. It appears they have been stolen.
Not good. Not good. Ogloff will be back here in 2 days expecting his shipment.
I am sorry, sir.
The shipment is gone.
There's just no honor among thieves. I'm a dead man. Unless... you again? Look, I told you, you were under consideration.
I want an Andorian ale, now.
And how, may I ask, do you plan on paying for such an expensive drink?
With these?
What's this? Telvarian money cards? These things are practically worthless on your home planet, much less in this bar. Look, friend. You find me some latinum, and then I'll pour you your drink.
Give me my ale now.
Look, friend. How about a roll of the cup? House is always blue. But if it comes up white, I'll pour you your drink. Otherwise, you go find me some latinum. Well, isn't this your lucky day? But you can't say I'm not a man of my word. You know, friend, instead of sitting here at the bar drinking, you should be at the dabble wheel. But not with Telvarian money cards! Latinum only!
Everything all right? Customers buying and paying?
Thank you very much.
Yes, it's getting busier as the night goes on.
Good. I've had to deal with a drunken and lucky customer tonight. A free drink. And then there's those stegomites in the corner over there, playing that game, Takfut. If board games catch on, there goes my profits.
At least they're ordering food and drink.
Fine. Just keep them well supplied. You know, first it was the root beer, and now this human strawberry juice. Thought I'd never get rid of this.
Yes, sir.
Oh, good, they're leaving. What about that hooded fellow in the corner? Has he ordered anything yet?
He hasn't ordered anything at all.
Nothing yet?
That's right, nothing.
Well, if he doesn't order anything soon, throw him out. That space could be used by paying customers. Ah, hello, friend. The games are open, and the Dabble Girls are at your service. What's your pleasure?
I'm not here for a game, or for the Dabble Girls.
Well then, friend, what can I get for you? If you don't order something, I'm gonna have to ask you to leave.
I want something to drink, but you don't have what I want.
I doubt that. In my storeroom here at Quark's, I've got everything that any species could want. Anything from Antarian Ale till Zeldar. So what is this drink that I don't have?
A Flobian Ale.
Fair enough. Where do I get this ale and how much is it going to cost me?
From me.
Don't tell me. You want me to purchase a few cases of ale from you at a huge markup. Before I do business with you, who are you?
I am Flobian, but I'm not here to sell you anything. I want a Flobian ale. This is how you make it.
Interesting. Complex, slightly potentially addictive, and profitable. And I see you named a drink after yourself. Nice touch. So is there anything else I can get for you around here? You know what? How about a roll of the die? House is always blue.
Quark, I'm not here to play your games. I'm here to talk to you about an important matter which concerns you and this space station.
As the humans say, I'm all ears.
You better be. When you had the station tracked to the neutral zone, you aroused the attention of the Orion Syndicate.
So, are you here to shake me down too?
I'm not here to collect protection, Latinum. The Federation, Klingons, and Romulans may care about the station, but they certainly don't care about you or your business. Each one of them is probably convinced you're working for one of the other. There are probably all kinds of open ears around here, if you know what I mean.
And for all I know, you could be one of them. Outside of this cheap drink recipe, what else do you have to prove what you're saying is true? Everyone and anyone has been trying to con me lately.
Satisfied?
You are a slave of the Syndicate?
Corroborate the number if you want.
No. I think that's all I need to know. So, why are you telling me this? What's in for you?
I have no love for the Syndicate. I escaped, but my family, my wife and my two daughters, they weren't so lucky. I was working on a plan to get them out, but I heard a report that they were killed as my punishment for escaping. What you need to realize, Quark, is that the Orion Syndicate has been running contraband all around this quadrant, because they are the only ones with the resources to get around interstellar law. Now, smugglers can come here and trade contraband without any concern for the Federation, Klingons, or Romulans. This also means that they do not have to deal with the Syndicate because of you and your station, Quark.
Anything else?
More importantly, Quark, all of the big players in the market will be coming here. Some of the players hate each other. Some of them would like nothing more than to kill each other. Now, if you and your station were caught in the crossfire...
I get the picture. So what do you think I should do?
First, keep the mixture for Flobian Ale in your database, in case I return and I'm thirsty.
Anything else?
Watch your back, Quark. You can bet they'll be watching you.
Good advice. But free advice is seldom cheap. Flobin!
Here goes nothing. Computer, open a secure channel to deep space. I mean, Bajor Station 1, such a bland name. Anyway, encode with cipher 2 grub 73.
Quark! Never thought I'd see your face again. If you're gonna try to sell me another case of shoddy neodymium coils, I'm gonna rip the little ears off your face.
This is not a sales pitch.
Then what do you want?
I'm in trouble. Nerys. Can I call you Nerys?
Go ahead.
Running the space station has proven to be a nightmare, and I think the Orion Syndicate's trying to kill me.
So you're in trouble. What else is new?
Major.
Colonel.
Right. Colonel, please. I need you to find Odo for me. As much as it pains me, I think Odo is the only one who can get me out of this mess.
Quark, Odo is 70,000 light years away in the Great Link. What makes you think he's gonna want to get involved with you again?
Colonel, please!
All right, Quark. I'll try to get in touch with him and explain your situation. But I can't promise anything. Oh, and Quark, you owe me big time.
Whatever is in my power to give you, Colonel.
Kira out.
Maria. Can I help you?
A Romulan ale.
Absolutely. There you are. One Romulan ale.
Thank you. This is real Romulan ale.
Did you expect anything less from Quark's?
This is real Romulan ale. Do you have a name, Ilarion? This station is very different from anything us Romulans have. I bet you hear a lot of things at this bar. Do you not speak?
She would not have been much of a challenge, even for you, Romulan.
You Klingons think you're so special, but all you think about is fighting and mating rituals. You know nothing of us Romulans.
And you are a typical Romulan, rude and unforgiving. It shows you have no honor.
Stop sticking your ridges into situations that are not your business. Why are Klingons always trying to provoke a fight?
I am Karnak, son of Ralmak.
Again, why do you Klingons always feel it necessary to announce to complete strangers your family lineage?
It is not my fault. You are so embarrassed about your family name that you keep it hidden.
I'm not embarrassed about anything, Klingon, save perhaps your fetid breath. I am Salius Tern, commander of the Romulan warbird Antillus.
Warbird? Ha! I'll bet it's like a garbage scow.
Garbage scow?
Gentlemen!
This station is supposed to foster cultural exchange between our peoples. Clearly, whatever disagreement you're having could be settled peacefully with a drink.
Who the hell are you?
Clyde Specter with the Galactic News Service. Can I buy you gentlemen a drink? The two?
Did I hear someone ask for a drink?
And then I was stripped of nearly all my honor and sent to this bloody end of the universe to be a sneak. Snoop. My last chance to regain my honor in the eyes of the High Council. Klingons do not snoop.
Oh. So, here we are. Klingon drunkard, a washed-up commander, and a journalist with one last shot at journalistic fame.
First, journalist, your story of being a journalist is the weakest cover I've ever heard. You're obviously a spy working for the Federation.
Me? A spy? Never. Maybe it's you who are the spy.
I'm the only one who is. I mean, there are no spies here.
Gentlemen, let's not fool ourselves. We each have a job to do here. We could easily expose each other, but that won't get us the information we need and won't get us a favorable report with our superiors. I say we work together. What do you say?
Yes!
No!
No!
Yes!
No!
Oh, come now. This station is supposed to be all about cultural exchange. What better way than to share culture?
I, for one, would like to know why the Federation towed a space station to the middle of the neutral zone and handed it over to an incompetent Ferengi, Spectre?
Search me. It's above my pay grade.
I heard you benefit from all the illegal trade going on here.
Federation would never...
Oh, save the propaganda, Spectre. We all know that behind this squeaky, clean, perfect society, the Federation is just as dirty as the rest of us.
That is not true.
Then why is this station here?
As if I know, why did your government allow it? We all know that Romulans don't do anything unless it's in their own self-interest. So why risk a neutral space station right at your doorstep? You even had to amend the Tree of Algeron to do it. Why the bureaucratic headache of all that? Maybe it's you who are benefiting from the illegal trade.
Quiet! All you two are good for is pointless arguing.
Our friend here is right. It's clear that none of us know much of anything, and there is a lot going on. So I say, again, let's all work together. Six eyes are certainly better than two.
And six ears as well. I can't argue with that.
So we meet back here in a few days then?
Agreed. Quark! More blood wine!
Another Romulan ale.
And a synth ale.
Who's there?
Quark, I hear you're in trouble again. Why does that not surprise me?
No, Odo, it can't be you. You're supposed to be with the Great Link. You're a founder. No, you're with the Syndicate. You're here to kill me! Wait, Odo! Odo, it is you! I'd recognize that sick clown anywhere! Odo! How can you be here?
Kira told me months ago, just after you bought the station, that you were moving to the Romulan Neutral Zone. I can't believe that I missed arguing with you and watching you lose those arguments again and again.
Why, Odo? You missed me.
No, Quark, I said I missed arguing with you. So, Quark, what's going on?
Odo, I need you. I am in so much trouble. My station is out of control, and people are trying to kill me!
Quark, you've never needed anyone before. Are you really that desperate?
Well, no. Not that desperate. Okay, wait! Yes, I am.
Then tell me what's going on, Quark.
Not here. It's not safe.
Fine. Don't you have a security office?
I didn't think I needed one.
Well, if this station is anything like Deep Space Nine, I think I know where we can go. So, Quark, what's going on?
I can't manage this station, Odo. Enemies are everywhere. Cargo is disappearing, customers are unhappy, and they're blaming me. The Federation wanted someone to manage a station in the neutral zone to bring together all the powers of the Alpha Quadrant. But all I wanted to do was make a lot of latinum, and that is not what's happening. People were supposed to come, stop, trade, gamble, eat, pay, and then leave. I even lost latinum over Ogloff's missing cargo. Odo, I'm in over my ears.
Is that all?
That's everything.
Quark, people would not want to kill you for doing those things. What are you not telling me?
Fine. Odo, it's like this.
Odo, I took a look at all the containers down in the cargo bay. All of it is either stolen goods or contraband.
Yes, Quark, your station is being used as an intermediary for contraband trading, and you're not even getting a percentage. Quark, you're putting yourself at risk of prosecution from the Romulans, the Klingons, and the Federation.
I know, Odo. Why else do you think you're here?
Quark, do you think the Romulans let you move this station to the neutral zone because they were being nice or wanted to promote peace? They're not that stupid or naive. The Romulans, the Klingons, and the Federation know there is a tremendous amount of trade and contraband out here. They are trying to stop it. They want to track it. They want to know where it's coming from, where it's going to, and what it's being used for.
I know, Odo! That's why I need you!
So what do you want me to do? There are no rules here, no regulations. You and the station are in a sector of space that up until now has had no boundaries, no limits.
It sounds so good when you say it like that. Odo, the potential for profits is huge!
Yes, while that may be true, you are not making any profit with this situation in place. And if you continue the way you are, you're going to get yourself killed. You need to have some rules and enforcement, Quark.
Odo, I have always followed the rules of acquisition.
Those aren't going to save your life or your station. You need security, rules to regulate trade, to make sure you get your profit, Quark.
Odo, I have always gone around your rules to make my profit.
How does it feel to be on the other side of the law?
Ironic?
Quark, without some laws on the station, you're dead. If you're dead, you can't enjoy your profits, and one of your family members is going to inherit all of your latinum.
Odo? Rule 143 of the Rules of Acquisition say that dealing in illegal goods can be very profitable, but very dangerous.
I don't care what you do as long as I can maximize my profits and not get killed in the process. It is not time for Rom to sell me off just yet.
The first thing we need to do is to get those security force fields around the cargo bays to protect them from outside transport. Just be aware, when those force fields are in place, you're going to upset a lot of people. A lot of very bad people, Quark.
Hansen. Your morning reactogeno?
Thank you.
And a list of today's repairs.
Oh. No lights on deck 3, section 4?
No.
The sanitary extractors are backing up in the entrance to pylon 3?
Yes.
No gravity on deck 15, section 3?
Again. Odo. Glad to see you up this early.
Yes, it was good to revert on a solid surface instead of a moving spaceship. I am Odo, the new chief of security. When will we have enough power for the security force fields on the cargo bays?
Mr. Odo, you must have just arrived at this station. It is not simply a matter of power. The Cardassians took many parts from this station to keep Deep Space Nine operational. We are trying to replicate those parts, but it takes both time and energy.
And latinum.
Yeah, sure. Yeah. Nibbles thinks we can have it ready in about a week.
Very well.
And Nibbles asks for his favorite food, hexatriticale.
Well, seeing as how you've been no trouble at all, you can have your grain by next week.
Computer, open a secure channel with Colonel Kira Nerys on Bajor Station 1.
Channel open.
Odo, what's going on? Why a secure channel? It's awfully late where you are, isn't it? Is Quark in that much trouble?
Kira, don't worry about what time it is here. I have something very important to discuss with you. I've just spent the day buried in cargo manifests trying to sort something out. I came across one very unusual item. A Vulcan ambassador named Takar apparently brought a Bajoran orb recovered from Vulcan aboard the station some time ago. It's being stored in one of the cargo bays. I was going to see it in the morning, but you told me all the orbs had been returned to Bajor.
Well, yes, all 9 orbs are on Bajor, and our Kai is very secure knowing that they are. Those records must be wrong. There are no other orbs. What does the manifest say?
Not much on the manifest, other than it describes a red Bajoran orb case.
Oh no, that's impossible. I've never heard of a red orb case. All the others are gold. Obviously you don't think this is a counterfeit, or you wouldn't be contacting me on a secure channel. So this is a real orb?
There is always a possibility it's a fake, but I doubt a Vulcan would make a mistake like that. That is what bothers me. What is a Vulcan doing with a Bajoran orb?
Bajoran religious texts only refer to 9 orbs, and none of them are red. Oh no, this could be very important to Bajor.
I'm sure the Vulcan High Command would be interested to know that one of their ambassadors has a Bajoran orb. I will contact them tomorrow to see what they have to say about this orb.
A red orb? Red is a very significant color in Bajoran religious texts. It signifies power. It could be very potent and very dangerous. Oh no, find out everything you can about this orb as soon as you can. I'll contact a Vedic friend of mine that I trust and see what he says. Who knows what this orb's unknown powers could create in the wrong hands, especially where you are.
Agreed. Kara, nobody knows that I know about this orb, as it should be.
Yes, I agree. The fewer people who know about this, the better. I'll let you know if I find out anything. You know, Odo, your quarters still look very sparse. I could send you some things you left here.
Yes, that would be nice. This station is still in a mess, but compared to the Link, I realize it's a much more visual place. I've also learned that Quark is in a lot of trouble, and he's even gotten death threats.
Quark's always in some sort of trouble. So was Quark surprised to see you?
Yes, I slipped into the bar when it was closed and formed right in front of him. He absolutely panicked. I'm lucky he didn't shoot me. He thought I was a founder, or that the Orion Syndicate had hired me to kill him.
I wish I could have been there to see his face.
So do I.
That reminds me. I've seen security reports regarding increased trading in illegal substances in your sector, especially weapons.
Yes, I'm sure those reports have something to do with activities occurring on this station.
Odo, let's talk tomorrow. Take care of yourself. And keep me apprised of anything you discover about that red orb.
Certainly. I will see what I can find out, and I will let you know.
Kira out.